Okay, here is a quick look at using the if statement in Excel using VBA, which is macros. So what I want to do is, let's assume that this is a grade for an exam or something, and I want to be able to click a button and I want it to tell me whether or not that is a pass fail. I'm going to add a bit more in for high distinction and credit. So the way that it works is, I'm going to pop a button in, and I'm here on developer. I'm going to go to insert, just going to choose this button here and just pop it in. I'm not worried about the name here, so I'm just happy with that. But if you do choose to give it a name, you don't have to put in, or you shouldn't put in, any spaces or unusual characters, but underscores are fine. So I'm just going to click on the new button now. So the first thing I need to do is dimension it. That's my variable, and you can see that I have a video on variables. It's either on my YouTube channel, you can search for it there, or on my website, jargonfreehelp.com, and look in Excel in the macros VBA section. So you do that by typing in dim. I'm going to call this variable my grade, and I'm going to do it as a byte because it's not a very, very big number, and it's a whole number. I need to input that into that variable. So I'm going to do that by telling it that it is the value that I've clicked on in the spreadsheet, which is called the active cell. So you can see that is just my grade equals the active cell. I'm just going to press enter. So the next thing I'm going to do is the actual if statement. So I'm going to say, if my grade is greater than or equal to 50, then I'm going to indent it now, because it just makes it easier to read when you're doing this. And as you do more of this, you'll see why. Message box, you passed. Okay, so this is always made up of if and then. So it's, if this condition happens, then you're going to do everything in the lines below it until you get to else. And then it will do whatever's below that based on it not being greater than or equal to 50. Okay, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to put in message box, you failed. And you need to tell it where to stop, and that's done by typing in end if and press enter. And you can see things like the else, the if, the end if, and the then. It capitalizes the first letter of each of those. So I'm just going to go back to Excel by clicking here. I'm just going to type something onto this button just so that we can read it. So I'm going to click here, then I click outside of it, and that's ready to go. I'm just going to click on that cell, because don't forget it's picking up the active cell there. I'm just going to click here, and it tells me I passed. I'm going to click on OK. I'm going to change that to 40. So we can see what happens. Make sure it's on that cell again. Click here. It's told me you failed. But what if I want to do a little bit more? Let's say, what if over 65 it's a credit? So that has to happen first. I'm going to go back to my macros here. Well, actually, I can click on Visual Basic on this button. I'm on the Developer tab. And I just need to change this. So I'm just going to take that 65, I'm going to do that, and I'm going to change that. I better keep this one. Well, no, I won't. Let's just fix this. So let's just change it. You got a credit. Now I'm going to have another condition in there. So if it's not greater than or equal to 65, I want it to be greater than or equal to 50 is the next one in the sequence. So I'm going to do else if. I'm going to do greater than or equal to 50. So if it's less than 65, it's failed that one, and it's going to move on to the next one. And then you need then again. And I forgot to put in my grade in there. So else if my grade equals 50. I'm just going to copy that so you can see if you've made a mistake in here. It does actually warn you. I'm going to paste that in. I'm just going to say you got a pass. Okay. And then I'm still going to have that else here. So if it's neither of those two, then it'll be that. Okay, let's just see what happens when I now change that. So let's go back to Excel. That will still work as the you failed. Let's change that to 55. Press enter. You got a pass. And let's make this one 70. You got a credit. There you go. So that's all working fine. So it's fairly straightforward. You're basically just getting it to check on this value here, which is my grade, and you're going to get it to check this condition to make sure that it works. I'm going to add in one more just so you can see it here, because I said we'd get a distinction as well. So this one here, I'm just going to actually copy it just to make my life a little bit easier. So let's just copy. I'm actually going to put that in above it. This one here really needs to be an else if, and I'm going to make distinction anything over 75. So you can see how the if structure works. And I have to start with this one here. If I had got is it greater than 50, and then below that was greater than 75, well, it will already have met that condition. So it wouldn't go onto that line. So as soon as it finds the right condition, it basically skips over all the other lines. There are all these other bits of programming. So when it gets to the right one, it will carry out everything underneath that until it sees the next else if, or else, or until it gets to the end if. Let's just see what happens if I put in a higher score now. It's always a good idea to check all of these things. Let's type in 80, and you got a distinction. Well done. So that's a quick look at using the if statement in Excel VBA.